Today is a very exciting day for us as readers because today we are starting our brand new reading unit on nonfiction. Before we get started, today you will need your whiteboard and your marker or your notebook and something to write with. So at this time, pause to grab those materials. Thinking about nonfiction. How is nonfiction different than fiction? Pause the video to discuss. What nonfiction topics do you like reading? Think about maybe some of the reading you've done in years past, or some of the reading that maybe you like to explore on Epic in your free time. Pause the video to discuss. What should we pay close attention to while reading nonfiction? This might be a tricky question, but when we're reading nonfiction, there are a lot of different parts to nonfiction. There can be on a page a lot of information, which is different than in fictional texts, where often on each page we have text and sometimes a picture. But with nonfiction, there can often be a lot of different things on the page. So what is it important for us to pay close attention to? Today, I want to teach you that readers don't see with their eyes alone, but with their minds. To read a text well, we need to understand the important parts of the genre, so nonfiction. The important parts that we're going to be learning about are main ideas and their supports. So that's a fancy way of saying main ideas and then the supporting details. Text structure. So sometimes text is written in chronological order. That means in order of the events that happen. It could be a cause and effect relationship. So when one event happens, it causes another event to happen. Problem and solution. So there is an issue going on and then it is somehow solved in the end. And compare and contrast. So two different topics are viewed to find similarities and differences. In the third bullet point, parts of the text and how they fit together. This could include a sentence stem like, this goes with blank because. Nonfiction readers know it pays off to think about all of these items. And today we're going to read a short nonfiction text called The Amazing Octopus. And as we're reading this text, I want you to be thinking of these three bullet points. And bullet point two and three are pretty tricky. So it might be a good idea to focus on bullet point number one. What are the main ideas and details of this text? So as we're reading, or I'm reading this text to you, I would like you to have either your notebook or whiteboard out so that you are able to write down notes. We will go over our notes at the end. Okay. This text is called The Amazing Octopus. Of all the strange and wonderful creatures in the ocean, one stands out. It is the amazing octopus. The octopus can be found in every ocean in the world. Octopus bodies. The octopus has a body that is different from any other animal. Its body, called mantle, is soft and shaped like a bag. The octopus can squeeze into very small spaces because it has no bones in its body. The octopus has 8 rubbery arms that attach to its head near its mouth. The octopus's arms are covered in suckers. The suckers help the octopus grab and taste things. The octopus hunts by grabbing its prey with its arms. Then the octopus bites its food with its tough beak and injects or shoots poison so the animal can't move. The octopus eats a diet of snails, fish, turtles, and even other octopuses. Octopus behaviors. The amazing octopus has many ways to defend itself. When an octopus wants to move fast, it can shoot out water to push itself backwards. An octopus can travel many miles that way. An octopus can also protect itself by squirting ink. The ink makes a predator or animal hunting the octopus become blind and lose its sense of smell for a little while. That gives the octopus a chance to escape. The octopus can change color to blend in. An octopus can even break off an arm if something grabs it. It can swim away and grow a new one later. So this picture shows octopus tentacles help the octopus grab things and taste things. The octopus shoots water to swim away from predators. Octopus brains. The octopus is a smart animal too. It can play games, throw and catch things, and learn shapes and patterns. Scientists think octopuses might have feelings too. They can change color based on how they feel. The octopus has an amazing body. No other animal is like it. And the last caption here, the octopus is amazing in many ways. Now, I don't know about you, Team Persevere, but from reading this short passage on the octopus, I learned so much that I had no idea about this creature. So now we're going to go back to our, let me just get this, our anchor chart. And I'm going to give you a few minutes to write some notes on this text that we just read, The Amazing Octopus. And think about these three bullet points, and maybe you'll be able to answer at least one of these. Main ideas and their supports. So that means, what was the main idea of this passage we just read and the supporting details? You could also think about answering bullet point number two, text structure. What way was this text put together? Or parts of the text and how they fit together. So maybe think about the different parts of the text, the different headings that we read about, and how they all fit together. Pause the video to complete this task. In this unit, we are going to work on summarizing nonfiction text and comparing and contrasting two different nonfiction texts. So by the end of the unit, you are going to strengthen your skills in both of these areas, and your new learning that's going to take place is going to help you complete a new project, an inquiry project, where you are going to be doing some nonfiction research of your own and sharing out that learning. So that's a little peek at a little preview of what's to come in the weeks ahead. Thank you everyone for your hard work today.